Merton the Mud Skipper. Of all the strange fish in the sea, Merton was one of the strangest. His eyes sat on the very top of his head, and his mouth was on the tip of his chin. Because he was different, all the other fish would tease Merton and call him names. To escape the teasing, Merton would swim away up to the surface. Here, he discovered that having eyes on top of your head could be very useful. For instance, he could watch the hungry seabirds without them noticing him. And he could watch the crabs scuttling about on the shore. But today, Merton could see a big, smoke-belching monster coming towards him. Merton called out to the other fish, "Flee, flee, swim away!" But they just laughed at him. Then, all of the fish disappeared, except Merton. Merton swam, and swam, and swam, until he could swim no further. Exhausted, he lay in the warm shallows, and despite feeling scared, fell asleep. Sometime later, Merton awoke with a start. "Where has the water gone? I can't breathe," he gasped.
"This way, quick,"
said Little Crab, waving his pincers. With several skips, Merton followed the crab and jumped into a small pool of water.
"Thank you so much," said Merton to the crab, whose name was Christoph. "What happened to the sea?"
Christoph explained that the sea goes out and comes back in twice every day.
"How will I survive until it comes back?"
asked Merton as the small pool started to dry up. Luckily, Christoph had a plan.
"I'll dig you new pools as I feed on the mud flaps," said Christoph. "You can skip from pool to pool until the sea comes back."
Hopping from pool to pool soon turned into a game.
"Look how well he skips over the mud. What's his name? I think it's Merton, ha! It's Merton the Mud Skipper."
Merton's skips and jumps became elaborate twists and somersaults which impressed all of the crabs nearby. Soon, the sea was back again. Merton waved goodbye to his new friend.
"I'll come back and visit soon,"
he called out. That night, Merton discovered that the sea had changed. There were very few fish. The coral was destroyed and dark, menacing shadows circled over the reef.
"I don't like it here," said Merton. "It was much nicer with my friend Christoph on the shore."
The following morning, Merton swam to the shore again and Christoph taught him how to breathe out of the water. It took Merton a long time to learn the trick, but after a lot of practice, he could stay out of the sea for many hours. There was no reason to go back to the scary sea now. Instead, Merton and Christoph spent their days playing together on the mudflats. Merton even built his home next to Christoph.
"See you tomorrow."
"See you tomorrow."
As time passed, other mudskippers joined Merton on the mudflats and he taught them how to breathe air. Merton had learnt that it is good to be different, and best of all, Merton loved his new friends and home on the mudflats.